Jim Alexander here with the real talker I'm speaking with.
Karlee Perez.
Karlee, what brings you out here today to this event, this premiere? Any special connection?
Just a lot of good friends on the show, so showing my support and love, and I'm a huge fan, so.
How did you connect with the cast? Do you remember the first encounter, meeting some of the actors from?
Well, one of my close friends is Goya, and I'm trying to think of our first encounter. I think it was like, honestly, I think our first encounter was through Instagram.
That's how it happens today, sliding into DMs and all.
It was like a couple years ago through Instagram, yeah. And ever since then, just the good friends and the rest of the cast is amazing, so.
Mm-hmm. I remember you from your wrestling days.
Oh, thank you.
There you go. But what has it been like, the transition from the wrestling industry into acting? I know you guys do a lot of scripted stuff. Did you feel like working for WWE and just in general in the wrestling industry prepared you for the acting, gave you some sort of, in a sense, training or background when you look back at it now?
In some ways it did. Definitely when it came to performing. There's nothing like performing in front of a live audience. That's a little different when you're on set and you can do 100 retakes. Mm-hmm. Not that you do that when you become to, you know, a certain point as an actor, and it's not easy, but it's definitely not easy going and performing.
You have 20,000 people booing you either.
So it all is, they're not the same, but it kind of goes hand in hand when it, comfort and confidence, you know, it taught me a lot of that, because for a minute, my first year in the industry, and I was like 19 when I started, I definitely was a little more shy around the camera in front of people and just talking, but over time, it just doesn't faze me anymore.
Yeah, I mean, that's exposure at a young age, too, you know, to such an audience, and that it kind of gets you comfortable, at least around people, in a lot of ways. Obviously, heard you talk about the research. Now it's wrestling getting back on network TV, more so with AEW and WWE. When you look at it from the outside now, at the industry, how do you feel about it in general, and being in the locker room, and being part of a transition period with the women's, wrestling, where now it's a lot more, you're getting main event matches, you're getting a lot more focus, and you're kind of right at the cusp or before it happened. Tell me what you see the industry now versus when you were in it.
It's definitely changed tremendously for the women, but everyone in general, but definitely the women. It's just a smaller percent of us in the industry. Mm-hmm. Our careers are very much more short-lived than the men, and they are giving the women not even the shot that they deserve. Just we're entertainers. We work just as hard as men do. So it's just, there's no reason why we can't entertain just like The Rock can entertain, you know. Mm-hmm. And then crossing over had the first year was definitely a little more difficult, and then by the third and fourth year when I started, people started to really look at my talent and not just view me as a wrestler. Mm-hmm. I was able to expand a lot more, so I'm grateful for that, and the business definitely helped in that way.
Was it tough for you to break out of that show? We see so many wrestlers turn actors, like that's becoming now, it's always been in the industry, but now more so than ever to become mainstream. How's it been for you, that transition to initially to get that acceptance as an actor and kind of that respect, in a sense, not coming from wrestling where it might be a stigma potentially?
Right. It took, like I said, I'm chewing on gum, guys.
It's all good.
The first year, I kept getting, and I'm grateful for the opportunity, especially the first year, because that was always the most difficult, but I kept getting the same genre of roles, and then by the third year when I booked a biopic, Mapplethorpe, and then I booked my first two films, and it was just out, and had nothing to do with the character I was before. So that's when the casting directors and directors really started to go, oh wow, we actually like what she's bringing to the table. And now I get stuff sent to me from all genres, which is amazing. So
pretty nice. And finally, what sort of things now that you're in the industry, what sort of things do you want for yourself to maybe work on, or you feel like you need to still grow at for you to get to the level you want to be?
I wanted to be one of the first women to actually transition from wrestling into Hollywood in a more serious light. Mm-hmm. Not so much in, I mean, there's nothing wrong with it, but not so much in reality television or any, or in the typical route that some of the wrestlers taking. I kind of wanted to do a lot more drama and grit, and I see myself definitely getting more behind the camera too, not just in front. So I've been actually dabbling into quite a bit of that. So
she's doing it all, transitioning in life now in the industry, and in many ways you're conquering everything. Thank you so much,
Karlee. Thank you.